So I've now started the recording. So again, welcome to webinar training using GoToWebinar. And so a little bit about what we're going to be talking about today. I do want to talk a little bit about just general webinar best practices. And then I want to go into the general functions of GoToWebinar. I believe most of the folks here today with us have access to a GoToWebinar account. If you do not, I think you're supposed to be able to, but if you would like to either put that into the questions pane if you do not have access to an account, and I can forward that message and your contact information to our Citrix program manager here at TechSoup, and she can respond to you directly. I think that would be probably the best way to go about that. So if you look at your screen right now, just know that this is what your participants would see if they came into a webinar using GoToWebinar. They would see the viewer window, so where you're seeing my PowerPoint slide, and then they would see the control panel, which is the box on the right-hand side that for you right now, you're seeing the audio controls and then the questions/chat pane. And then to the left, you're seeing a little string of buttons called the grab tab, and one of those is an orange arrow that you can use to minimize that box. So just keep that in mind that this is exactly what your attendees would see if they entered a webinar that you were holding. And that's a little bit of a diagram of exactly what they would see on that control panel. It might be a little bit different because this picture might be a little bit out of date, but this is approximately what they would see. But that's not the only level of participation in GoToWebinar. Right now, everybody is on the attendee level. So you can see the audio pane and the chat pane. And you can, of course, type in questions to organizers and panelists. So everybody on the back end who's presenting the webinar, you can send them questions and we can see them. But anything you're typing in, other attendees cannot see. And that's something that's actually really, really important to believe. Or important to know. And then if you are a panelist, your control panel looks pretty much the same, but you can chat with other organizers and panelists, and you can show your screen if the control is given by the organizer, which will make a lot more sense in a couple of minutes. And Chris says, and this is an aside, Chris says that he believes that it's two partner, let me see what this says, that it's two Citrix accounts per partner NGO is what should be the allowance. So again, if you do not have that account information, go ahead and send me that request and I'll forward it to Barb. And then finally, and this is the top level of participation, and this is what I'm entered in as right now, and what Anka is organizer. And we can see a couple of different panes that you're not seeing right now. And I wanted to tell you that because I'm going to go ahead and upgrade everybody to organizer so they can go ahead and see everything that the control panel has to offer on the back end. And that way they can chat with other attendees if they would like. So I'm going to go ahead and upgrade, and I will be keeping an eye out to see if anybody else joins us, and I will upgrade them at that point. If you lose your audio momentarily during this transition, that's normal and you should regain it within a few seconds. And what that did is it went ahead and unmuted you, because while attendees are muted when they enter, organizers are actually usually unmuted. I'm going to go ahead and mute everybody again, simply because I believe it makes using GoToWebinar a little bit easier and a little bit more streamlined, but we'll talk a little bit about that best practice in a little bit. So I'm going to go ahead and mute everybody. But one thing I do want you to notice that in the chat pane now, so now you have a questions pane, which is where the questions from the audience come in, and you have a chat pane. If you go to that chat pane, there should be a drop-down menu at the bottom where you can send a message to organizers only, to organizers and panelists only. Or you can send a message directly to another person. And it does look like we just had a few more people join us, so I'm going to be watching to make sure they get access to the audio. This is actually a good time for them to join us. Yes. So for everybody who just rejoined us, if you could go ahead and let me know that you can hear me. That would be great. Go ahead and type that into the questions pane. We did just get restarted just a few minutes ago, so you haven't missed an incredible amount. And what I'm going to do, and this is what I was talking about before, is that what the people who just joined us, what you're seeing right now is what the attendees see, is what people who just joined us see. But I'm going to go ahead and upgrade you so you'll be at the end where you can see everything that everybody on the back end sees. So I'm going to go ahead and upgrade you. You might lose your audio for just a moment, but it should come back. All right. And as everybody, I think, just heard, when somebody's upgraded to be an organizer, they do automatically become unmuted so they can speak to everybody. I'm going ahead and muting everybody, and I'll talk about that best practice a little bit later and why I prefer to do that. But what I was just saying was that the box on the right-hand side of the screen is where all the controls for the webinar live, and it is called the control panel. You will now have a few additional boxes on that control panel. One is the questions pane, which is where the questions from the audience come in. And one is the chat pane. And why I wanted to upgrade everybody to be an organizer is not only for them to be able to see everything that GoToWebinar can do, but for you to be able to talk to your other attendees. Because if you're an attendee, you cannot talk to each other like you can talk to a presenter, but you can chat with other organizers. So if you go to that chat pane, you can go ahead and select one person to talk to, or you can say to all organizers and panelists, so I'm going to type that in. Hi, everyone. Glad you can be here. So go ahead and feel free to utilize that chat pane whenever you'd like to today. And again, thank you everybody for rejoining us today. I apologize again for the late start. I think it's going to give us something to really substantial to talk about when we get to the troubleshooting section. So thank you. And the little string of buttons next to that big box is called the grab tab. It will look a tiny bit different than this picture because this picture is a little bit old. But you do want to make sure to notice not only the mute button, but then also notice the the orange arrow. The orange arrow is how you go, the orange arrow is how you go ahead and minimize the control panel. And so really quickly, what I wanted to talk a little bit about is what is a webinar. If everybody could go ahead and type in what they think a webinar is, I think that would be a really great first step. So go ahead and type in what you think a webinar is. Thank you. Chris is saying an online tool for sharing educational content, and I think that is something that that's a really, really good definition. Anka is saying, I think it's a seminar, educational meeting in real time online. That's another really good, that's another really good definition. Magdalena is saying, from my previous experience, a very good way to share, present, participate, and share. Again, great.